What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Umpire Game Channel. My name's AJ Gels. How y'all doing? We are back with WWE 2K20. Going to be, want some more skills. I think we're with, we're with the male character right now. Let's go up here. Why not? And get some submission defense. Offense. More offense. I'm trying to think. What did we do in the last video? We participated in the Royal Rumble. We went in, I think, at 23rd. It took me a little bit to end up winning. Well, even though I guess there were 31 competitors, because eventually The Rock showed up. But eventually, we won the Royal Rumble, and looks like we're gonna be facing off against Samoa Joe at WrestleMania. That's what happened for Trey on Red's side. She won the WWE Divas Championship against Brooklyn Von Braun. And I think that's all the important highlights. No, I do kind of wish though that we'd see the division between Brooklyn. Or not Brooklyn. See a little bit more division between Trey and Red. It just seems like every time something happens that, you know, would kind of cause some division between them. And they even reference a few times, oh yeah, sorry I was kind of mean, or I wasn't like fully behind you or whatever. Just every opportunity that they have to show stuff like that, they just kind of gloss over it. I don't know. I mean, I get why, but I feel they could have done a little bit of a better job with it. You know, showing that division between the two, I think it would have been a much more, I think they could have done some more interesting things with that. Just, I don't know. That's my opinion. Now, come on. Give me some reversals. Yeah, like I said, I'm looking for more reversals. I've only got three with Red. I'd love to have a few more. Let's start chapter 17. We've got this chapter and then one more after it. There's going to be, I believe I looked this up, there are 18 total chapters. And also, just know that once we're done with my career, we will, how to put it, it's not the end of this series. We will be doing one more thing. With WWE 2K20, we will be playing through the first showcase that was released, which is all about the Women's Evolution and the Four Horsewomen. So, stay tuned for that if you're interested.
You always were an overachiever.
You here to demand your rematch? Because I have no problem beating you again tonight.
There's not going to be a rematch.
You're giving up that easily?
No, there's not going to be a rematch because you're going to announce your retirement tonight.
That's news to me.
It's why I wanted to find you first thing, so you could start writing your big farewell speech. But that kind of emotional garbage should actually come easily to you. I mean, if you get stuck, you could just borrow something from your earlier writing. You've probably asked yourself a million times, why? Why didn't they want to be my parents? The truth is, we did, but we had to make the hardest decision of our lives because we didn't feel we could give you the life you deserved. Garbage, garbage, garbage. Love always, your mom and dad. That's right. I found out you wrote that little piece of fiction kicking off 20 years of lies to your best friend. His real parents are dead, and you've been stringing him along this entire time, making him think they're alive just so you'd have one friend in your depressing life. You never told him the truth, even when he continued to pathetically leave two empty seats for them that would never be filled.
Why? Why are you doing this?
The why?
Because she's an asshole?
Doesn't really matter. Right now, you should be more concerned with the what, as in what could happen next. I could expose you and all your lies, destroying your life, your reputation, and most of all, your friendship with Trey. Or You can retire immediately, and I'll make your secret my secret. But one way or another, it's happening tonight.
I know walking away from everything you've worked for will be the hardest thing you've ever done, but you have to keep our secret. Please.
You know, I think I started out kind of liking that whole young Red talking to older Red, telling her to, you know, keep the secret or whatever. I kind of liked it all the way through, even though I still find it funny that it looks like they've never aged, but whatever. I don't know. It's starting to wear thin on me. I don't know. I put that up to the comment section. I mean, what do you guys think that are watching? Like, do you still like it, or are you kind of like me? It's just kind of worn thin. Like, they haven't really done anything interesting with it. I mean, they did have that one time where Trey's adopted parents were sitting and talking in the school cafeteria.
That's how I won the WWE Divas Championship, crossing off one of the most elusive things on the list. But the Divas Championship wasn't just a title.
That's my mom and dad.
It was more than that. It was...
Sorry, I think something amazing just happened.
Oh yeah, I forgot they had. She hadn't told. Yeah,
to meet
sorry.
My birth parents at the Hall of Fame ceremony tonight, and I think they just arrived.
I don't know what's happening.
I apologize if I'm a little distracted.
Who are those people?
I've been waiting for this moment my entire life.
We're almost done here, so I'll catch up with you real soon, okay? Sorry again for cutting you off. Where were you?
There's really not much left to say. Other than to cover how we ended up here tonight.
I kind of lost where I was going with that. Oh yeah, that weird scene early on where it was Trey's adopted parents like having the conversation that his birth parents were dead, yet it was played off as a flashback, and you know, you saw young Red kind of walk in on them, even though it all kind of took place in the cafeteria. I think it would have worked better to actually have that inside a house instead of just seeing the character models. That was really odd to me. And again, it's like I said, the
lifelong nemesis to capture this championship.
I don't know.
The same championship I dreamed of winning as a young girl.
The weird flashback characters are just
amazing feeling.
I don't know. Like I said, worn thin to me. And the belt's morphing through her
of different emotions,
weird roadie shirt.
Ones that I hadn't felt in a very long time. Satisfaction, relief, peace of mind. The fire that drove me throughout my career to come out here and fight on a nightly basis was suddenly gone. I went from thinking, what's next, to what's left. And I realized that after crossing off the most elusive item on the list, the answer was not much. Because I accomplished everything I set out to do and way more. So I had to be honest with myself. If I kept going, everything after would feel like a letdown. And that's not how I want to live my life or remember my career. So with all that being said, I'm here tonight to relinquish the Divas Championship and announce my retirement from WWE, effective immediately.
Is this actually happening?
I love how the guy with the marry me, I'm single sign put it down nice and slow, like, oh.
I know this is probably shocking, and some of you might be disappointed or upset, but this isn't necessarily a bad thing. I've lived this part of my life to the fullest, and now it's time for me to go explore other challenges. And who knows? Maybe I'll try acting again. You all saw how my only other audition went. Can't go worse than that, right? Finally, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for supporting me for all these years. Please continue to back the next women who take my place, who I am certain will be stronger, more athletic, and hopefully a little less temperamental than I was. So, yeah, that's it. Thanks, everyone.
I'm not really sure what to say. I'm stunned.
I think we all are. No one was expecting this.
Thank you, Red. Yes, thank you. And we wish you all the best.
For a second there, I thought they were going to try and break out the thank you chant. The speech, I don't think was one of the best retirement speeches I've ever seen. I mean, it's kind of hard to get that emotion, you know, the exact emotion right, doing something like this when you're not actually have been living this life and, you know, doing this day after day after day and all that. So, you know, writing it and then performing it in a booth has got to be a lot of difference. But again, I still go back to, I still get almost welled up a little bit. It reminded me a little bit of when I saw my favorite wrestler, Edge, and I know I keep coming back to this, when he retired the day after WrestleMania, beats Alberto Del Rio, retains it, first time he's ever retained a championship at WrestleMania. Sorry, I'll finish this in a second.
I'm sorry, but I need you to try to understand.
Maybe I could wrap my head around it if I had a little more warning. I mean, when you texted me, make sure you watch my promo tonight, I was expecting you had some clever line about Brooklyn, not that you were going to walk away from WWE.
This wasn't something I was planning for a long time. It happened quickly.
Okay, fine. But if you're done, then I'm done. We're a package deal, remember?
No, what? Don't do this.
I need you to try to understand.
What about the title shot you just earned in the Royal Rumble? And getting revenge on Samoa Joe for everything he's done.
None of that matters if you're not along for the ride, too.
You need to think about this some more. You're making an impulsive decision.
I've made up my mind. I'm done.
Yeah, finishing what I said, okay, never mind. We're right into another scene.
I never expected my plan to work this well and cause your idiot friend to retire too. It's like getting rid of two turds with one stone.
This isn't over.
But it is over. And that's the best part of all of this. Anyway, just wanted to wish you a happy early retirement. Maybe you can take up bingo or going to dinner at 3 p.m. or yelling at kids in your neighborhood. If you kick that ball in my yard one more time, I'm going to put you on my list. Hilarious. See you, never again.
Walking away, lifting your legs up like that, it's gotta be tiring. But no, finishing what I was saying, no, I remember the night after Edge beat Del Rio, you know, comes out on Raw, he announces his retirement due to the flaring up of his old neck injury. And then when he went out on SmackDown that following Friday, because that was back when SmackDown was taped, and then aired, you know, he came out, he has to do his entrance one more time. Just
let me run through it once to make sure I've got it.
You know, leaving the belt in the corner as he walked away. It was great.
Prepare yourself for drama as our contestants get their hands dirty, glad handing with the CEO of a manure company to see who can get the upper hand for their fall fertilizer campaign. It's all hands on deck. Coming up next on America's Next Top Hand Model. Do you think there's too many hand puns?
It's perfect. It's not heavy-handed at all.
I see what you did there. Hey, sorry I missed your other call. I'm at my new hosting gig. Look, if this is about getting Baron Corbin a spot on the show, I'm still relatively new here, so I don't think I have that kind of pull yet. Oh, okay, good, because honestly, I don't think Baron's hands are anything to write home about. Wait, what'd you say? Really? That's amazing! Did you tell Red yet? Yeah, she's been hard to reach lately. Okay, I'll try her. This is truly an honor. Thank you so much. Ah!
gonna be famous-er. I'm gonna be famous-er.
Yes!
All right. Yeah, just finishing whatever I was talking about. Yeah, I mean, that was it was not only just a great moment just watching, you know, a guy like that just put everything he's got out and everything. It made me cry. It was such a well-done moment. It just everything about it. If there was a way he was going to leave, it was perfect.
In my championship. I hate you, Brooklyn.
You drunk? Can they not show that in a 2K game?
What?
Hey, it's been a while. How's it going?
I'm great. I'm on vacation at the beach, which is why no one's been able to reach me. I'm trying to disconnect, you know?
Oh, that's good to hear. I only have a minute, so I'll make this quick. I just got some amazing news. We're going into the WWE Hall of Fame together.
Really? Wow, I'm shocked. I mean, I thought it would happen someday, but definitely not this fast.
They didn't say this, but I'm assuming they want to capitalize on my crossover appeal as host of ANTHM.
I'm sure that's it.
I know we didn't expect our careers to end the way they did, but it's nice to know we accomplished enough to go into the Hall of Fame. And more importantly, we're going in together, just like it's always been.
Yeah, it is nice.
Hey, I gotta run. Don't relax too much. You know what they say about idle hands. Ooh, I gotta work that into tonight's show.
Congrats.
You too. Ooh, I wish I could see Brooklyn's reaction.
I'm sure she won't be happy. Which makes me happy.
Move! Don't look at me! Don't look at me! Get out of my way! Are you kidding me? Those two pieces of human trash are going into the Hall of Fame? This has to be a joke! They were only in the WWE for a cup of coffee. You know what? An actual cup of coffee deserves to be inducted before they do!
Take it easy. We're all entitled to our opinions, but there are certain realities you can't dispute. While Red and Trey may have had shorter careers than the typical Hall of Famer, the impact they made during that time was tremendous.
I love his see-through beard.
If you or anyone else disagrees, they are going to get the recognition they deserve.
We'll see about that.
Again, I love his see-through beard. It's almost like the visuals in this game are crap. But I couldn't... Oh, wait... I don't know, man. It seems weird. We're already now kind of coming back into the to our current time period. Or that's not the right way to say that. We're catching up to where to present day. There we go. I don't know why I couldn't say that the first time. Already in chapter 17, I figured that would be the end of chapter 18. I don't know, like, unless they're gonna say hold the announcement, you know, we got one last thing to do and then go compete at WrestleMania or something. But it also doesn't help that, you know, like I said, because we can't tell how the characters age, how long it's been. Ha, I get it.
I think that pretty much sums everything up, right?
Yeah, I think we covered it all.
Oh, okay, nope, I guess we are.
Thing left to do. List, please. It's time to cross off one final list item together. Get inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame.
Quick question. What about the Dusty Classic, the Best of Five series?
Seriously?
All that
I've
stuff?
Got one you can use.
I'm sure someone else in this arena has a spare pen, so you can go sit down.
Take it easy. I just wanted to come up here in front of the world to say congratulations and finally put our differences behind us. I would never do anything to take away from your special night that you so rightfully deserve. Trey, even your birth parents are here, which is amazing! Stand up, please! But before you finish up, there's just one thing I want to mention that you left out of your speech. You see, Red wasn't 100% honest about what led to her retirement and later her best friends. In fact, it turns out she has a little secret. Which is the real reason she walked away from WWE.
You have to do something. She's gonna ruin everything. I'm sorry, but I'm done hiding this for us.
it's
yeah,
her.
It probably wouldn't have been smarter to do that. I found out the truth. I don't know. This secret months ago.
And she didn't want me to tell anyone. So she chose to retire instead. But I couldn't sit back and let her get away without everyone knowing the real Red. So let's start with this. That lovely older couple in the audience, they're not Trey's parents. I know, because they're fakes I hired to be here.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that kind of makes you look really bad. I'm also just throwing that out there.
But if you want to see your real parents, I can make that happen. Here they are. Yeah, that pretty much says it all. And look at the date there. They were already long gone by the time we were in high school. Which makes you wonder, Trey, how could they have written you a letter? Maybe someone else wrote it to try to manipulate you into doing whatever they wanted. And maybe that person was so miserable and lonely, they had to resort to something morbid like that to ensure they always had a friend at their side. But who would do such a terrible thing? Certainly not your so-called best friend, right?
Is this true?
Am I the only one who thinks what Brooklyn's doing is worse than what Red did?
We're not finished here. If you come any closer, I will crush his neck. And the same goes for anyone else. If you try to stop us, I will end him.
All right, now I can actually get through a full thought instead of getting a bunch of half thoughts out here. Now, again, I think what Brooklyn was doing was way worse. Was what Red did misguided? Sure, but you can at least understand where she was coming from. I mean, obviously, I'm not, you know, actually Trey. I'm not in that position, you know, so... Maybe it's a little different if you're in that, you know, maybe I can understand if he'd need a little bit of time to, you know, kind of process everything. But at the end of the day, you can understand why Red did it. What Brooklyn was doing, hiring fakes, sending that letter, showing the actual tombstones, that's, yeah, that's scummy. Now on to something from, like, the actual way the game has been designed. The way the story's constructed, it made it seem like this would be way further in the future than just... I'm trying to think here. I don't know. It seemed like this would be way further in the future than the... I don't even 100% sure... I'm not even 100% sure what year it is currently. Basically, what I'm trying to say is... In the last chapter, I figured even this stuff would be way further in the future. It just... The passage of time in this game has been very complicated. Or not complicated. Has been poorly portrayed. There we go. To me. It's just... I'm not sure how long we... You know, because we never even get a screen saying 3 months later. Or so many months later. Or so many years later. It's just... You know, a decent amount of time, you kind of have to pick up certain context clues here or there. There was that one time that Red was, oh, well, I'd held my WWE Women's Championship for 2.5 years. So you go, okay, so this is 2.5 years from a date that I don't know. It's just figuring out where everything happens relatively to each other chronologically is just a bit of a pain in the ass to me. And I mean, it's been one of those things that's bugged me, but I've been able to get past it until now when we kind of connect the flashback of what's been happening to the current day timeline. Or not, again, I keep saying the wrong word. Not timeline, but the current day story. It's just... The way everything's connecting to me is it's just not good. And do we need another goddamn loading screen? We've seen it before, where they've gone from cutscene right into gameplay. Why are we going through these loading screens? I've been able to put away like the weird little quirks. I mean, yeah, I know I've been bitching about the fact that the game just looks dumb, or looks terrible, or that the story's a little dumb at times. But in all honesty, I'm just making jokes. You know, I at the end of the day, I don't really care. It's been enjoyable. This is actually where it's gotten to the point where, okay, this isn't even fun. It's just distracting and annoying. And what the hell are with those pants? Oh no, she's tearing up that piece of cardboard. Yeah, it's like I said, okay, there we go. That was chapter 17. Okay, that was easily the worst chapter of this game. Just the way it was set up, the design, all the loading screens that kept happening that I still don't fully understand why they were happening that way. I hated that chapter. It was god awful. I think that this game has had weird little bugs and quirks, and as a whole, would I score this game highly? No. What I say is it at least fun to play through the campaign and ignore a lot of the, you know, just kind of crack jokes at the stuff? Yeah, it's fun. I wouldn't necessarily say go out and buy it for the long run, but, you know, like I said, if you can pick it up cheap, whatever. This chapter really made me lose a lot of my opinion. I'm sorry that I can't seem to form a coherent sentence here. It's like I said, it's just baffling me how they have gone from quirky and flawed, but still good, up to this crap. I thought this chapter was just god-awful. It had nothing to do with the length either. It just was not good from a design standpoint, from a writing standpoint. Just about the high point was Red's, her retirement promo. Other than that, I thought this one was just god awful. I don't know how many more ways I could say it. Guys, thanks for watching. Social media is down in the description. Like, comment, you're not already, please subscribe to the channel. Hopefully we're gonna move on to something better in the next one. But until then, guys, my name's AJ Gales. This is Soundline Game Channel. I'm out.